This week, the Minister of Finance, the Honourable Matia Kasaija, presented the national budget for the year 2023-2024 before Parliament, as well as the President and the whole country. And there are areas that stood out, and these are what we are going to be looking at today in the Business Roundup. You are welcome. My name is Viola Kusasira. And joining us is Paul Busharizi, who is going to be our analyst tonight. Thank you, Paul, for making time to be a part of the Business Roundup. So talk to us about some of the areas that you think were the reason as to why we see a growing trend in economic growth, as mentioned by the Minister of Finance.
Well, the economy, I have no reason to doubt the Minister. The economy is growing, driven by services, industry and agriculture. Industry, a lot of it was to do with oil and gas. There's a lot of investment now in the oil and gas to get it ready for first oil. And services, of course, you know, things like telecoms have you know, they've continued to remain profitable, continue to show higher revenues. Banks, retail services, of course, are getting back into action after COVID. So I think it's I have no reason to doubt the minister.
Agriculture and industry were pointed out to have been part of the areas that grew so much, and also which are going to receive big budgets moving forward. So what do you think we got right, and how best can we ensure that agriculture grows and literally multiplies more than we already are observing?
No, agriculture always grows. I think it's safe to say, I can't remember the last time the agricultural sector didn't grow. I think probably when there was a drought or too much flooding or something like that, but it always grows. So the question is for everyone to benefit, is we still are growing in raw materials. We're not growing, okay, we are, but we're not growing in processed materials or not. And that is where the action should be. That's what we should be counting more and more.
And finally, Paul, President Museveni, while observing the budget that was being presented, mentioned that there was going to be, moving forward, cutting of expenditure on public officials' vehicles, as well as trips and many other things. Do you think this is applicable, and what do you think is going to happen when this kind of expenditure is reduced finally?
I think even beyond before corruption, we talk about corruption, these expenditures, there was always scope for cutting them down. Foreign travel, workshops, I said new cars every so often. Yeah, the allowances, you know, once you don't travel, no allowance and all that kind of business. So it's long overdue. We've talked about this forever. I hope, you know, there's some serious commitment this time around. But there's a lot that has to be done in public expenditure. We urgently need to cut down on public expenditure. The budget is 53 trillion. Of that 53 trillion, URA is expected to bring in 29 trillion, which leaves you with 24 trillion. Which is going to be borrowings. We come from borrowing abroad and here and stuff. But of the budget of 53 trillion, between 17 and 19 trillion is going to go to debt servicing. The problem with this, of course, is that one way of looking at it is that, look, if URA brings in 29 and 19 goes, therefore we're left with 10 to work with. Another way of looking at this is that it is the biggest single call on the budget. It's actually 36% of the budget. You know, human capital development, which is education and health and whatever, only take on 18%. And then governance and security take on 15%. So there's a problem there. And the problem is not that we're borrowing a lot. The problem is even the money we borrow, we don't even use it, and yet we're paying interest. The minister revealed last week before the budget that 15 trillion just is lying around that is unused. 15 trillion of our debt. And it's costing us about 2 trillion a year to service. Imagine you're paying for something you don't use. Imagine you borrow money to buy a TV and then you don't buy the TV, but you're still paying for it. So double loss. You're paying for it, you don't have enjoyment of the TV. So that's our real problem, that we're not effectively using the money that we borrow.
All right, so Paul, thank you very much for having made time. We appreciate your analysis on the budget. And thank you very much, dear viewer, for having made time to watch the Business Roundup. We bring to you stories happening in the world of business every week on Friday. I am Viola Kusasira. Back to the news.